Hey guys, welcome back to the Game Replay. I'm Dave the Usher. The game we're playing is The Last of Us for the Sony PlayStation 3. Good stuff. Here we are. We're gonna maybe perhaps check on Joel, help him, but then I have a feeling like some shit's gonna hit the fan. We gotta have like one last showdown encounter here. Let's do it.
You better be alive, Joel.
Is hurrying a factor?
Ellie, they're almost through.
What if I had just waited? Hard to say. And that answers that. My God. Jesus, I just made it.
Through here.
You almost shot me. You almost shot me.
Ellie, you with me?
Yeah, Mom, I'm right behind you. Keep running.
This reminds me of the first part of the game. Oh, dude! Not a good idea. Bad idea. It's a gangbang feeding.
Up the stairs. The scaffolding, that's our way out.
I guess I'm a little bit further than I ended up, huh?
Infected!
Oh, they're behind us too!
This way!
I just didn't care, I guess. Can I close the door? Oh,
go, go, go.
God! Run! It's, jump!
Ellie! I'm good, just keep going!
Oh.
There's an open window! Come on!
Better put my light on, just in case
We're
I need
almost
it.
Out.
Up! Up! Eh, piece of cake. Alright, man, we got this thing.
Reach up, I got you!
Hold on,
give me your hand! Quickly, get out of the
truck! Ellie! I think it's clear.
Ellie, your arm.
No.
Don't worry. I've done this before. I'm kind of an expert. Ish. Just stay calm. Stay calm.
There's some more stuff over there you can break.
Do.
The way I see it, we got two options. Option one, you take the easy way out. It's quick and painless. I'm not a fan of option one. Two, we fight.
Fight for what? We're gonna turn into one of those things.
There are a million ways we should have died before today. And a million ways we can die before tomorrow. But we fight for every second we get to spend with each other. Whether it's 2 minutes, or 2 days. We don't give that up. I don't want to give that up. My vote? Let's just wait it out. You know, we can be all poetic and just lose our minds together.
What's option three?
Sorry. Come on. Let's get out of here.
That is The Last of Us Left Behind DLC. Just recently came out, and it looks like I finished it up. And what do I have to say about it? I think all good. I kind of like how they left things. I wouldn't have mind, if they had a little more conclusive scenes, you know, wrapping things up. They kind of want to just leave it there for you, you know? You know what happens, and, you know, that was pretty much the origin of Ellie's bite, I guess. I mean, we know how she's gonna be okay. And her friend, not so much. We don't really know precisely how her friend goes down, you know? Does she turn and then put out of her misery? Does she kill herself? Does someone kill her? Bop-bidi-bop. You don't know. You can pretty much figure it out that it's not gonna end good for her, and Ellie's gonna be a little surprised with how things work out. For her. And the scene with Joel, alright, Nellie, she took care of him and bandaged him up. Oh, company mascots. Took care of business and took him out of there. I really was hoping for one last scene, maybe for some fighting. But I can understand that being kind of the big showdown. I was actually hoping for a little more zombie action. And maybe because I only picked, like, normal setting. I wonder what things would have been like if you went for, like, kamikaze, crazy-ass setting, you know? That could have been even cooler. But that is The Last of Us Left Behind, the DLC pack. And it's definitely worth a pickup for a couple of reasons. It's fun to play, something, and with something different if you're a fan of this game. Even if you've just seen my walkthrough, I think it's a good idea to pick this up because you're gonna wanna, like, change up the difficulty. And I believe in this game, when you do that, there's, like, more to encounter. Yeah. and that could have happened. Things could have been a little crazier, like that last scene, for instance. There could have been maybe some more, like, zombie dudes, and that could have been cool to, like, up the difficulty. There was a couple of bombs and a couple of Molotovs I didn't get to use because I kept on thinking there would still be that one last scene, and I wouldn't have mind. That would have been fine. Like, if she went in there, went, "Joel, I got the medicine, everybody!" And then, like, fixed him up, and, then she heard, like, another noise outside, and there was, like, that one, you know, one last showdown, maybe. That would have been cool. And then she, took Joel out of there with the horse and all that, but that would have broken up the momentum, maybe a little, also, of, like, how the last scene went. With the music and, like, the back-to-back cutscenes, because they put them, like, together. So it was all, you know, it was all fancy and nicely done. But it was good, man. So, what more do I have to say? There's a lot of cool news with The Last of Us. They're talking about, well, first of all, they're talking about, a feature film. That'd be cool. There's really not much to be said about that. I mean, they're in talks of doing a film based on this game. So are they going to use the same characters and do it that way? Or is it going to be, like, different people? I don't know, man. I think either would work, I guess, even though we pretty much know how this story goes. So, I mean, it's not really big in the surprise department. So I think it could make sense to go a different route, you know, with different people and all that. Who knows? Who knows? But, yeah, there was also talk about, another Last of Us game. Sequel, prequel, just another type of Last of Us game. I don't know, that's all up for debate right now. A lot of people want, you know, what happens after the conclusion of this game. You know, people want the events to continue with these characters. Some people are like, no, man, that's done. Let's move on. Let's go a different route. You know, use different people. And also, time is a factor. Time is a factor. You could go, maybe a little more closely after all this stuff happened. And I'm kind of in favor of something like that, you know? Let's get a little fresh. Let's get more fresh. You know, let's not wait 20 years. Seems like, it seems like we're in the road category. The road, the novel, the movie that was based on, it just seemed like really depressing. Like, a lot of people are really done, you know? This is like leftovers. Like, Thanksgiving was had, and now we're in the leftovers department, and there is not much to do anymore. I feel like maybe if we go back and, you know, different characters and go more closely to after all this shit, that could be cool. Yeah, there you go. Good stuff. So, I'm in favor, okay, I'm definitely in favor of different characters because I don't want to do anything with, Joel and Ellie. I think that's wrapped up and I don't think there's anything left to do with those people, you know? They could ruin it, you know? I think it's played its part and that's all. So either go with a new story in the same timeline of, you know, after 20 years since the infection thing has happened, or, you know, or go closer back to when this happened, you know? Maybe even, like, during. That could call for a lot more work, you know? A lot more people, a lot more mayhem. I don't know, it kind of has this whole bigger budget kind of atmosphere when, you know, when you say, you know, when you want to get closer to this apocalypse. Yeah, I'm going into interrogation, by the way. I'm going to do a quick interrogation. Yeah, just a quick match for a little bonus, because I think we have a little time left over. Okay, so we're going to be searching for our optimal game. An optimal game, not just any game. This is going to be good stuff. Hopefully it's an interesting match. I want a fun, crazy, funky match with weird stuff. Glitches are fun. Sometimes, like, bodies, like when you kill a body, like they bounce around and it's kind of odd, or they like float up to the sky. I don't know, it's really funny. It's like ghost deaths. They're ghost deaths. The only thing I wish they like added to this was, I don't know, maybe either like an escalation type mode where you fight like infected dudes, on different maps altogether. I suppose the same maps. Now, they'd have to be, like, differently designed maps. So, new maps with, like, you know, rounds and fighting infected Briz. And just, you know, with a team, of course. Yeah, you need a team. That could be a lot of fun. You could set bombs. Oh, man. Come on, guys. Why didn't they do this? They have to do this with the next game. They could set bombs and traps and, I don't know, maybe they could have invented a couple of other things, like booby trap-wise, to have for this escalation Last of Us mode. What was I talking about? I don't know. That would have been fun. Come on, man. I see people, what, like they're not good enough? They're good enough. They're good enough, I guess, maybe. Well, they're enough, okay? Just come on, let's get into a game here. I don't know. Yeah, it would have been cool. Escalation Last of Us mode where infected dudes were coming out. Or what if it was like, oh yeah, I was gonna say, what if it was like a regular team deathmatch kind of thing, one team against the other, but also there were just, hey, just for fun, they were like infected just running around. And, oh man, and here's where the good ideas keep flowing. And I'm sure no one has thought of this ever until me. What if, you know, while you're team against team, fighting off each other and infected alike, what if you get bitten, or whatever, and you actually turn, and you become a part of the other team, which is now this newly infected team? Like, it starts with AI, maybe, and then it gradually is replaced. Or what if it's just, like, three teams all together, you know? Two teams against each other, Fireflies and the Hunter dudes, and another team just starting out as infected. And that team can actually grow because they, you know, they bite you and they infect you and bring you over to the other side. And eventually, I don't know, I guess one team would always win. Well, maybe not necessarily, but it would be tough. I think that's actually a really cool idea. What are the chances of the Naughty Dog Briz listening to this? 100%. Yeah. Take some of my ideas. Someone, take this and send this to them. They need to listen. They need to hear this. I think some of that could definitely work. A lot of it is like a lot of, I don't know. I think all of it could work, but it's pretty elaborate. Thank you. Yes. Shit. Oh, it's not the beginning, I think, folks. Hopefully it's right at the beginning. I believe these timers start with 15 minutes. So I really hope it's kind of at the beginning. That would be cool. Suburbs. Have I shown the suburbs yet? I don't know. Oh no! This is not ideal. Okay, folks, so it looks like I'm gonna be starting this match a little later rather than sooner, but you know what, that's okay. It's also okay that their bar is filled up with interrogations and they're heading over to the safe right now and that guy's dead. And, okay, and now they're cracking the safe. This is not the son of a fish. This is not the best way to start. Come on, there we go. All right, so, okay, what do we do? I'm just gonna try and do what I can here. Ugh, I think I got one guy down though. Just trying to buy a little time. Yeah, that guy's down. I was hoping to... What's up with this guy? Well, I was hoping for interesting, weird, wacky shenanigans, and that guy doesn't have a face. Guy has no face. Okay, so this is bad. They're opening the safe. Shit. Ah! Come on, come on!
One less tourist!
Alright, where'd the other guy go? Alright, fuck him, I guess. Let's get this guy. Come on, come on, come on. Damn it! Alright, I guess he was back there the whole time. Alright, so this is not ideal. This is not the ideal situation, folks.
Smoke, watch it!
But it's okay. It's okay, I welcome a challenge. So what if we only have one interrogation and their interrogation bar is filled up and they only need that, you know, that small bit there to finish this round, and there's only 8 minutes left in the round, and I'm not having a good start, not really, but I joined this match late, and I'm gonna do everything I can to help out, man, and who doesn't love a good comeback, man? Especially a kick-ass comeback. Alright? Things can't get any worse than this. Die! Die! I'm having deja vu. Alright, good stuff. Let's get some interrogations here. Hurry it up. There you go! Double it up, man. Double it up. But we still need two. Yeah, this really, right now, this is called defense mode. All four of us are gonna be right here because we have nowhere else to go. Why would we go anywhere else? We got nowhere else to go. I have nowhere else to go. Except for this safe that has vital information about... I don't know, man. I never know what's in these safes. Documents, important documents. I'd like to think, like, I don't know, the whereabouts of supplies and valuables. It's not like there's cash in there. I mean, who gives a shit anymore, right? That's, meaningless. I guess, knowledge is power, so whatever's in there is, like, good to know. It's good information, and it will help.
Good to go.
I just think supplies and stuff like that. Oh, wait a minute. There's a guy over there. Right now, I'm really trying to be, like, sneaky, sneaky cat here. Maybe I'll down a couple with a flame ball and... See, what I want to do is shiv one. I think this guy saw me. Shit. Alright, I'll get you! No! Oh, God. Oh! Oh, that didn't work, man. That didn't work. Shit! Okay, so there's 6 minutes left, and we need two interrogations still. That was an oopsies. That was a fireball in the face oopsies. A fireball in the face variety oopsie. That's what that was. I hate it when that happens. We've all done that, I think, while playing this game. Accidentally giving yourself the old fireball. I'm gonna just try and cat myself around here. Sneaky, sneaky. I gotta shiv this guy. I gotta shiv one of these guys. Maybe this guy? Come on, come on, finish him! Nice! I got him. So right now you're probably noticing, wow, there's like four of the dudes over there. Why don't they make the break for the safe? Here's the thing, folks, and I think I touched upon this already. In interrogation mode, or all the modes, you're trying to do the 12 weeks thing too. You're trying to complete your objective, and that can vary, you know. You gotta get a certain amount of downs, or kills, or special kills, or Molotov kills, or, you know, whatever, man. There's a bunch of them. So, oh! Give him the shivity! Booka! Hey! Hey, man, we got that gauge filled up.
Keep breathing. I got this.
Shit. Shit. I don't have any shivs. Where is he?
One less you.
Ah, there we are. Booka! Wanna shoot you in the ass! Yeah, he's dead. Anyway, so we all have our objectives to do, trying to do that 12-week thing, keep people alive, so we can get a little star. That was weird. We want to get those little symbols next to our names, right? Because it's important. So here's the thing. Some people don't like to finish the match, even if that can result in, like, an accidental loss.
All done.
You know, it's kind of like rolling the dice a little bit, having your cake and eating it too kind of thing there. You know what I'm saying? So, basically, when you're the other team in that position, you're gonna kind of string things along so you can have a little more time to do some damage, especially if you're giving the other team an ass-kicking, which this team was getting when I entered this game. I think I might try and attempt some attacking right now, by the way. So, one might call it, showboating, you know, bad sportsmanship, you know, put the bad team out of their misery, for God's sakes, just end it! But actually, you know, it's all about preference. The bad team, the one that's getting its ass kicked, may actually prefer, no, it's cool, alright, this sucks, I don't like sucking, but yeah, string it along, maybe I can pick up some more stat boosts and all that stuff for my situation as well. I guess I'm hanging around here a little more. I don't know what to do right now. So, yeah, it can vary from player to player, you know, that the team could get pissed off, like, you know, stop humiliating us, just end the damn game. Where's that guy's face, by the way? I don't know. Or, you know, the other team could be like, well, why don't we put them out of their misery? Like, this seems silly. And I used to be kind of like that, but... oh, man, this is bad. Oh, nice! Oh, well, yeah. At least I got rid of that bomb. We're still in this. I used to be kind of like that, like, yeah, dude, let's just end this match. You know, I'm not gonna prolong things, but... at the same time, you could tick off your teammates, like, bruh! Trying to complete my objective. I needed two more deaths, and now, well, I'm fucked. Thanks. And you don't want to be that guy. So, usually now, I will, I'll play till the last tick. And if I'm on the, attack, and I'm doing the safe thing, after the second gauge is filled up, I'll stop, and I'll be like, yeah? Yeah? Is that cool? I look around, and it's not like I'm talking to him, but sometimes someone else, like, comes over and, like, starts doing it. I'm like, well, dude, like, why do you think I stopped? And I'm like, you know what, whatever. But I like to be that guy now that's like, all right, you know what? We all have our objectives. We're trying to do our thing. And sometimes that backfires. You know, a couple times I could have finished it or someone else could have, and we lost. Or the other way around. Sometimes the other team... well, this could be good. The other team could have been kicking our team's ass, and now we're coming back, and this could blow up in their face! Okay, that's two, that's two! Oh my god, oh my god, am I gonna make it? There's about a minute left, I could be the hero! Oh! Buka! How about that for a comeback? My guts are hanging out. Yeah! Not too happy about that now, are ya? Good stuff, hey! And that's the kind of match I wanted to get in real quick. That was a good match, man. Good stuff. So this was a fitting way to end things, you know? Let's just have a little quick old match here in interrogation mode. The mode I like out of all the other multiplayer Last of Us matches more than anything else. So there you go, guys. That is the Last of Us Left Behind DLC pack. It was pretty cool. Definitely worth a pickup. Everything about it was just awesome. I wish... sometimes I wish there was a little more battling throughout the game. I think they could have thrown a little more zombie action and all that stuff into the mix. I think there could have been... I think the final battle could have been bigger, but that could also have to do with the challenge modes, you know, making it tougher. And, hey, that could make things more crazy. Who knows? But, guys, that's it. I'm going to continue with some more multiplayer matches in the future, but right now I'm going to call it a wrap. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Of course, leave me those comments and tell me what you think. I'm Dave the Usher for The Game Replay. Stay tuned for the next part of The Last of Us. I will see you guys next time. I am out.